Welcome to the case summary for Basic Incorporated versus Levinson on FourLawNotes.com. This was a class action lawsuit where shareholders were suing the directors of a company. Representatives of the company were in dialogue with another company concerning the possibility of a merger, and they'd had several meetings and telephone conversations. But while these discussions were going on, the company made three different public statements. The first one said that they were engaged in merger negotiations with another company, and then the second and third announcement said that they were not in any negotiations for a merger. Then one day they announced suspension of trading of their stock, and the next day they announced that they were merging with this other company. So the shareholders were suing the directors, saying that they had sold their shares at a depressed price on acting on reliance of their public announcements that they were not in merger negotiations, and that the company was in violation of SEC Section 10B that basically says that it's unlawful to mislead and make any untrue statements of material fact, or to omit a material fact. And the issue is whether misstatements of information regarding merger talks materially affected trading of securities in violation of SEC Section 10B. The U.S. Supreme Court in this case took this opportunity to articulate the fraud on the market theory, which deals with the causal link between a misstatement on the part of a company and the price of the securities. And in the past, individual investors had the burden of showing proof of actual reliance on a public misstatement. But in this case, the court held that individual investors are entitled to a presumption of reliance on misstatements. They don't have to show actual proof. But having said that, relating back to this case between the shareholders and the company, the court also held that materiality in the merger context depends on the probability that the transaction will be consummated or that it won't be consummated. So they remanded the case to make that determination. And that concludes this case summary for Basic Incorporated versus Levinson on FourLawNotes.com.